Friends, let us continue with your chapter number 2, Historiography, Indian Tradition. Okay, in the previous video, we have gone through the ancient history of India. We are just going to study about India in this chapter. So, we have studied about the ancient history of India, then we have gone through the medieval history as well. There, we have talked about many books which are written by the many historians, like many books like Babur, Abul Fazl, yeah. And then we have also studied about Bakar. Bakar is a very important document, which was also written in the medieval period, and that's right about the history of that all the leaders and heroes and their struggle. Then we have gone through the modern history. Okay, modern history may be studied about the British period, but Britishers, whoever were the historians in the British period, English historians especially, they were very much like partial. They used to write the good things about the Britishers and the bad thing about history. They were not showing the correct picture of history, right? So we have done that, and if you have forgotten, please go back and see that video once again. Okay, and also we have covered up one more thing, that is ideological framework, that we have done colonial historiography about colony period, then orientalistic historiography, which is very important. Orientalistic historiography is basically like such scholar people who were Europeans, but they were more interested and they had a very good pride for India, and they wanted to study about more in detail of Indian history, right? And they also concluded that Sanskrit is the mother of many Indo-European languages, and they have translated many our grants and other sacred books into the other languages, translated into many more foreign languages. Even we have done nationalistic historiography. There we have talked about many national leaders. Example, you have R.K. Rajwade, Rajendra Lal Mishra, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar. We have studied about them also in their philosophy, what they stated in their books. And the name of the book is also important. So let us continue with your continuation part, that is post-independence period. There we had stopped last time, and today I am continuing with that. Okay, so in this we are going to talk about the post-independence period. Mention the year post-independence period. So I am on a page number 11. Please open that page with me. Okay, let's start. Now, along with the writing, the dynastic histories, the cultural, social, economic histories were also being written. Okay, underline this line, what all things were to be written. The cultural history, economical history, dynastic history, in sab ke upar bhi history likhne ki shuruaat ho chuki thi. Scholars of the post-independence era, begin to feel the need of writing histories of various communities, sciences, economic systems, political ideologies, cultural aspects, etc. Matlab, historiography was just not related to whatever happened in the past. Some historians in the post-independence period, they found a need of writing the histories in other aspects, in other factors as well. Kaun se factors unko history likhne science ke upar bhi, matlab science mein kis tarah se progress hua, how was the science earlier, what all discoveries were done, then communication ke upar, political ideologies ki kaun se leaders the, kaun se parties thi, then economical system ke upar, to in sab ke upar, all these factors ke upar bhi kya likhne mein aayegi, history likhne mein aayegi. The historiography of this era has been influenced mainly by three ideological schools. You need to remember this three ideological school, and there are the short notes. If you see the question number 6, these are the three questions. May say the third one is Subaltin. The second one is, okay, that though we have already gone through, but third one, we need to do that. Subaltin historiography, yeah? And this we will cover up in this section today. Even there are some more questions based on the other history part, I mean the feminist and other things. Anyways, Marxist historiography, let us talk about that first. Marxist, jaise hi word Marxist aata hai na, you should be very much clear with the word Marxist. Marxist means what? Yes, you got it right. In the previous chapter, we have done about the Karl Marx. If you remember Karl Marx theory. So this Marxist history is dependent on Karl Marx theory. Okay, Marxist history is dependent on Karl Marx theory. The concern for the means of production, modes of production, and the industrial relations were at the center in the writings of the Marxist history. जैसे Marxism, अगर आपको याद है, हमने Marxism, Karl Marx के theory में यही पढ़ा था कि means of production should be in the hand of those who produce, right? तो यहाँ पे भी यही कहा है कि modes of production क्या produce करना है, कैसे produce करना है, industries कौन run करेगा, उस सब का control किसके हाथ में होगा? That's all about Marxist historians. According to analyze, the impact of every social event of significance has remained the basic theme of Marxist historiography. Marxist historians in India studied the transitions within the caste system. Among the notable Indian historians who adopted Marxist ideological framework, scholars like Damodar Dharmanand Kosambi, Comrade Shripad Amrut Dange, Ram Charan Sharma, Comrade Sharad Patil have contributed notably. You must underline these all the leaders' name who are the Marxist ideology ko jisne frame kiya hai, who had established this Marxist history. The names are given, few names, you have to remember them all. Okay, these are the main name of Marxist historians, and those they emphasized on the means of production, modes of production and industries should be in the hand of people who work. Unka ye manna tha, theek hai? Comrade Dange, comrade is basically a ek category hoti hai army mein, jaise hame pata hai marshal hota hai, chief marshal hota hai. Okay, वैसे ही comrade is a one of the title given to the army people. So he was an army man, yes, and he was one of the founder member of the Indian Communist Party, and the name of his book written by him was Primitive Communism to Slavery. Primitive Communism to Slavery, ये इन बुक का नाम है जो किसने लिखा था. Yes, it is written by Dange, comrade Dange. Alright, and that book was about Marxist history. It was about like primitive communism to slavery. Slavery मतलब कि जो गुलामी है, गुलामी से किस तरह से आज़ादी मिले, और किसकी किसकी गुलामी से, ब्रिटिश ऐसे तो हमें आज़ादी मिल गई थी, लेकिन फिर भी हमारे इंडिया में बहुत सारी गुलामी होती थी. मतलब कि अपर क्लास लोग अभी भी गरीबों को गुलाम की तरह ट्रीट करते थे, तो उनसे आज़ादी पाना. अंडरस्टूड. नेक्स्ट वन इज सुबल्तन हिस्ट्री, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द सीड ऑफ सुबल्तन हिस्ट्री आर फाउंड इन द मार्क्सिस्ट हिस्टोग्राफी. द रोल ऑफ द इटालियन हिस्टोरियन एंटोनियो ग्रामसी is very important in developing the idea that history should be written starting from the bottommost ranks of the people in the society, and that is called bottommost ranks. Okay, subaltern ka matlab samjho, easy meaning of subaltern means bottommost. Bottommost matlab sabse last ka, sabse last hai, that is called subaltern. Yani history should be written keeping in the point of view of bottommost people, jo log बहुत डाउन क्लास है. डाउन क्लास का मतलब दे आर हु आर वेरी इकोनॉमिकली वीक, फाइनेंशियली वीक. ओके, उनका जो कास्ट सिस्टम में भी उनकी गिनती बहुत लो कास्ट में करने में आती है, तो दैट पीपल कम्स अंडर द सुबल्तन हिस्ट्री. यानी सुबल्तन हिस्ट्री इज़ ऑल टॉकिंग अबाउट सच क्लास ऑफ पीपल हु आर वेरी वीक फाइनेंशियली, इकोनॉमिकली, कास्टिज्म के हिसाब से भी, तो उनके ऊपर हिस्ट्री लिखने में आई है. एंड देर आर मेनी लीडर्स, वन ऑफ देम वी नो डॉक्टर अम्बेडकर, हु वॉज इन अ फेवर ऑफ अपग्रेडिंग एंड अपलिफ्टिंग सच अ क्लास ऑफ पीपल. ओके, डाउन ट्रोडन के लिए वो उन्होंने बहुत मेहनत की है. एंड देर आर मेनी मोर लीडर्स ऑल्सो जो हमेशा क्या मानते थे, देर इज़ नो कास्टिज्म. मतलब ये जो डिस्टिंग्विश होता है वन क्लास से दूसरे क्लास का, ऐसा होना नहीं चाहिए. मेनी लीडर्स हैव try to remove this injustice from the mind of people. So let's read further. Folklore has been considered as a very important source of writing Subaltern history. Folklore मतलब के ऐसी कहानियाँ जो हम अपने दादा दादी से सुनते आ रहे हैं. ओके, ऐसी कहानियाँ. रंजीत गुहा, underline that, an Indian historians played a major role in establishing Subaltern history as the important academic school of historiography. सो रंजीत गुहा कौन थे, वो भी एक इसी क्लास के एक पर्सन थे जिन्होंने क्या स्टार्ट किया, ही स्टार्टेड सुबल्तन हिस्टोग्राफी. हाउएवर वी मे पॉइंट आउट दैट मच बिफोर द ऑनसेट ऑफ सुबल्तन आइडियोलॉजी सिमिलर थॉट्स वर एक्सप्रेस्ड बाय महात्मा ज्योतिराव फुले वेरी लॉन्ग बैक. इंडिपेंडेंस पीरियड में ही महात्मा गांधी, हमने देखा है महात्मा फुले है, डॉक्टर अंबेडकर, उन्होंने कितनी मेहनत की थी ये कास्ट सिस्टम को हटाने के लिए और सबको एक करने के लिए. दे हैड ट्राइड अलॉट, बट वी विल मेंशन देयर वर्क इन दिस चैप्टर एज वेल. महात्मा गांधी फुले अनफोल्डेड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ शूद्र अति शूद्र. यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस नेम, शूद्र अति शूद्र. शूद्र मतलब क्या, शूद्र यानी कि शूद्र इज़ वन ऑफ द वर्णा. ओके, जैसे चार वर्ण है ना, उसमें से जो फोर्थ वर्ण है, फोर्थ मतलब वर्ण इज़ बेसिकली अ कास्ट सिस्टम. पहले के ज़माने में चार वर्ण होते थे, तो फर्स्ट में क्षत्रिय आता था, वैश्य, ब्राह्मण एंड शूद्र. तो शूद्र यानी कि बहुत ही लोअर क्लास पीपल. तो शुद्र अति शुद्र यानी लोअर टू लोअर क्लास पीपल कम्युनिटीज इन दिस बुक गुलामगिरी. तो उन्होंने एक बुक लिखी है गुलामगिरी, वेयर ही ड्रू अटेंशन टू द एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ वुमेन शुद्रस एंड अति शुद्रस डन अंडर द नेम ऑफ रिलीजन. He had showed the actual fact in his book. What did he observe? He observed that was a lot of exploitation going on and it was happened on women, Shudras and Ati Shudras. Ati Shudras are even more poorer than poor. The term Shudra and Ati Shudra indicates the bottom most ranks in the caste system. Okay, so we are very lucky that we have not been a part of that period. Otherwise, we would have gone and suffered through a lot of problems and troubles. Continuing, the role of the people belonging to the Dalit caste. Now they are called as Dalit. Earlier they were known as Shudra. Unka bhi naam badalne mein aaya hai. They are now called as Dalit. Is very significant in the aspects of India. Unki struggle bahut lambi chali hai. Dalit ko apna hak paane ke liye bahut mehnat karni padi hai, bachcho. However, their role was not duly acknowledged in the colonial and nationalistic historiography. Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, focusing on this fact, consistently wrote about it. Two of the books, you must remember his books, what he has written, two books, and that is also based on the Subaltern history ka hi part tha. And the books' names are Who were Shudras and the Untouchables. Even इनको Untouchables भी कहा जाने में अछूत. Okay, Untouchables means अछूत. बहुत सारे लोग उनको अछूत करके बुलाते थे. तो in his book he has and he himself was Dalit. We all know. वो खुद एक Dalit family से belong करते थे. But he fought against this odd. He said that I'll not believe in Dalits and all. I am a human and I will be a human. No casteism, no religion can distinguish me from the human. Maybe cited as example of history of Subaltern type. So I hope you understood what is Subaltern type. It's about the bottommost people, unki life, unki history, unki struggle ke upar ye sari books likhi gayi hai. Now comes to feminist historiography, which is all about women. Over a significant period of time, mainly male scholars were involved in the writing of Indian history. Yeah, hume jaise last chapter mein humne kiya tha, first chapter mein bhi, ke all the historians, yeah, the history was only about male. Male was a self-centered person. Unke upar hi zyada history likhne mein aati thi. Okay, female ko to koi like position hi nahi thi. There was no any rights given to the female. But I mean, after the post-independence, women ki jo condition thi, wo sudhe, you know, dheere dheere इम्प्रूव होने लगी. इवन उनकी लाइफ को भी लोग डिपिक्ट करने लगे, उनकी लाइफ को भी दूसरों तक पहुंचाने लगे कि हाउ दे आर लिविंग, व्हाट इज़ गोइंग ऑन इन देयर लाइफ. तो हिस्ट्री आई मीन इनके ऊपर भी हिस्ट्री लिखने में आई. ओके, सो एज अ रिजल्ट द रोल एंड अचीवमेंट्स ऑफ वुमेन इन हिस्ट्री रिमेंड निग्लेक्टेड. आई एम ऑन अ पेज नंबर 13, द लास्ट पेज नाउ ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. टू हाईलाइट दिस फैक्ट वॉज अ मेजर टास्क फेस्ड बाई द फेमिनिस्ट हिस्टोरियंस. तो इस टाइम में जहाँ पे हिस्ट्री में सिर्फ मेल ही मेल थे, तो वहाँ पे फीमेल के बारे में कुछ लिखना कौन पढ़ेगा? बिकॉज मेजोरिटी पीपल विल बी इंटरेस्टेड टू रीड अबाउट मेल. नोबडी वॉज केयर अबाउट वॉट इज गोइंग ऑन इन फीमेल्स लाइफ. बट देर वर द फीमेल हु हैड टू रेज या वॉइस फॉर फीमेल. ओके, सो देर वर सम वीमेन हु स्टार्टेड राइटिंग देयर हिस्ट्री एंड देन लेटर ऑन पीपल स्टार्टेड लविंग देयर हिस्ट्री, पीपल स्टार्टेड रीडिंग देम. Also, it was important to study the compile the historical writings of women. It was also necessary to rethink of women's position in history. Obviously, women's position was inferior compared to men. Women position हमेशा से कैसी रही है? Inferior रही है. लेकिन ये inferior position में भी there were some scholarly women who did not lose hope, who did not just give up. They have tried to show their position, they tried to show their talent. And which are these women? Among them, there was in 19th century Tarabai Shinde, जिसका नाम आपने पहले भी सुना है, and the book which was written by Tarabai Shinde. She was the foremost woman. She wrote attacking the male dominated social system and caste system. And her book name is Stri Purush Tulna. Stri Purush Tulna. Stri yane female, Purush yane male. Un dono ki tulna yane ki comparison. And that book was published in 1882. Okay? ये book तभी publish करने में आई थी जहाँ पे लोगों को women के बारे में कुछ पता ही नहीं था, या women क्या feel करती है वो कोई किसी को पढ़ी नहीं थी. ऐसे टाइम में ये book लिखी गई है. But female ने ये books को पढ़ा. I mean बहुत सारी women ने they started loving her book and they started encouraging her. So it was in 1882 1868, the book written by Pandita Ramabai was published, entitled The High Caste Hindu Women. Another book again written by another woman, and she was Pandita Ramabai. Wo bhi ek scholarly women the. The feminist literature of the post-independence era concentrated on the issues like employment of women, treatment meted out to them at their workplace. Okay, let me explain you employment of women first of all. See, employment of women means women should also get a chance to work in the government offices or in the private offices. Earlier, only the men used to get a job. Why? Because men agar women job karti hai, to obviously koi bhi banda jo usko hire karega, he will think, bhai women ko to ghar ka bhi sambhalna hota hai, to wo office kaise sambhal paegi? She cannot able to handle the office as well as home. But later on, women have proved herself that she can handle the house as well as she can handle the office. So it's about employment of women. The next point is treatment meted out them at their workplace. Yeah, very inferior treatment was given to her in the workplace. Unko barabar ka darajja nahi milta tha. Women ko inferior treat karne mein aata tha at a workplace. They were being exploited. They were being harassed by their superior authority, by the male workers. The right to political equality. There was no right earlier about the political right. मतलब उनके कोई वोट करने के उनके rights नहीं थी. They cannot contest the election. They cannot participate in or they cannot be a part of any party. बहुत restrictions थे. But later on, as we can see, now time has changed. Right? So among the recently published feminist literature, Meera Kosambi's book. ये बहुत recent अभी हुआ है in this century itself. The name of the book is Crossing Thresholds. Okay, and feminist essays in the social history is the important. It contains essays on the life and the life stories of women like Pandita Ramabai, Dr. Rukmani, the first practicing lady doctor in India. Yeah, hame yaad rakhna hai Dr. Rukmani jo pehli lady doctor the. Doctor bahut the lekin pehli lady doctor was Rukmani Bai. Okay, and Rukmabai. A lot of literature is available unfolding the viewpoint of Dalit women in history in Maharashtra. Dr. Sharmila Rege's work is noteworthy in this context. Her book Writing Caste, Writing Gender, Reading Dalits Women's Testimonies. Testimonies matlab about their life history, about their biography. Includes her essays on the autobiography of Dalit women. Now let's read about Do You Know? Publication of Marathi Riyasat by Govinda Sakaram Sardesai was a momentous achievement in the field of Indian historiography. Ye do you know sare aapko learn karne padega, matlab they have to be like objectives ke liye aa sakta hai. So you need to remember the name of the book, written by whom, about what. Okay, his work became so famous that people began to address him as Riyasat Kar, kyunki unka book ka naam kya tha, Marathi Riyasat. Riyasat matlab kya, Riyasat means like a dynasty, like unka. Okay, तो उनको क्या नाम से, उनका नेम एक्चुअली था गोविंद सकाराम सखाराम सरदेसाई, बट पीपल स्टार्टेड कॉलिंग हिम रियासत कर. ही पब्लिश सेवरल वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ मराठा हिस्ट्री एज वेल लेटर ऑन. नाउ आई एम रीडिंग फर्दर. देर हैव बीन अ नंबर ऑफ इंडियन हिस्टोरियंस हु रोट विदाउट एम्ब्रेसिंग अ पर्टिकुलर आइडियोलॉजी. मतलब देर आर सम हिस्टोरियन जिसने कोई ये तीनों में से किसी एक को, एक के बारे में नहीं लिखा. इधर दे रोट अबाउट फेमिनिज्म और दे रोट अबाउट मार्क्सिज्म, या नहीं तो उन्होंने सुबलतन के बारे में लिखा. दे हैव रिटन समथिंग एल्स ओनली. ओके, मतलब जनरल टॉपिक के ऊपर. अमंग देम हिस्टोरियंस लाइक सर जादूनाथ सरकार. यू विल स्टडी मोर इन डिटेल द नेक्स्ट चैप्टर व्हाट दे हैव रिटन. ओके, सुरेंद्रनाथ सेन, रियासत का जी एस सरदेसाई, जिनके बारे में हमने ऊपर पढ़ लिया है ऑलरेडी. देन वी हैव सुरेंद्रनाथ सेन. ओके, वी हैव त्र्यंबक शंकर शेजवलकर. दीज आर द अदर हिस्टोरियंस हु हैड नॉट एक्सेप्टेड अ पर्टिकुलर एनी आइडियोलॉजी. दे यूज टू राइट एनी जनरल टॉपिक. इन द रिसेंट टाइम्स हिस्टोरियंस लाइक यशवंत दिनकर फड़के, रामचंद्र गुहा एक्सेट्रा हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड एक्सटेंसिवली टू द हिस्टोग्राफी ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया. ये भी आपको सारे हिस्टोरियंस के नाम लिखने हैं. आई टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी, एक चार्ट बनाना है आपको. आप चार्ट मुझे फॉरवर्ड भी कर सकते हो, करना ही है इनफैक्ट. यू हैव टू मेक अ चार्ट बाय थ्री कॉलम्स, नेम ऑफ द हिस्टोरियंस, द बुक्स रिटन बाय हिम, एंड द व्हाट स्पेसिफिक अबाउट द बुक. मतलब कौन से ईयर में पब्लिश किया है, या वो बुक किसके ऊपर लिखी गई है. जस्ट फ्यू लाइन्स अबाउट दैट हिस्टोरियन. ओके, ऐसे तीन कॉलम का एक अच्छे से पेज में बना दो एंड वो स्टिक कर दो इस चैप्टर के साथ साथ, ताकि आपको बार बार ये चैप्टर रीड करने की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. आप वो सिर्फ रिवाइज कर लोगे टेबल, इट विल बी इजी टू यू. सो मेक योर ओन टेबल, राइट. Then in the recent times, okay, last paragraph, thus it is evident that the Indian historiography has been influenced greatly by the social and political movements. It seems that some part of the Indian historiography was also developed outside the influence of this movement. Yani we can say that India was getting progressed in the history part. Social and political movement ki wajah se India ki history aur kya hone lagi, badhne lagi, progress hone lagi. Okay, now I have already gone through the objectives and some question answers. And question number 6 jo maine kaha tha tab nahi karna lekin abhi you can start learning as I have covered up all the answers. Orientalistic historiography, there is an answer here on page number, we have already done it. Number is 10 and the answer is from, yes, beginning, many Europeans se lekar, we have the answer till literature and history. Okay, till literature and history. If you see the third paragraph of 1784 wala, that, till that. Then we have next question, nationalistic historiography, which is again on the same page, nationalistic historiography on page number 10. From the dha writing of Indian se lekar, yes, you can write some names as a historians. Bahut sare naam diye gaye hain aapko on page number 10 ke last mein agar aap dekhoge ya 11 ke starting mein dekhoge. Aapko sare naam yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, you can just learn few of them, 4-5 is enough. So entire paragraph. The next one is Subaltern history, just recently done Subaltern history, coming to the page number 12. Now this answer will be little bigger because you need to write entire thing unke sabke bare mein, ye pura answer learn karna padega. Yes, I'm not joking, but yes, you have to learn the entire answer. It's a quite big answer, I know, but aapko pura the seeds of Subaltern se lekar, you have to learn till untouchables may be cited as example of history of Subaltern type entire. This entire, it's a big answer, need to learn entire. Okay, so here we are done. Objectives part, you have to learn it. And then I am going to take a test of this chapter 2 orally on Zoom. So be prepared. Bye-bye.